Wherever you are, wherever you are in your relationship with Jesus right now, and however you're serving God in your university campus, you need some time to reflect. Reflect at the end of the year or end of ministry cycle. Either way, it's needed. Hi, my name is Jermaine Gale, and I would like to talk to you about reflecting on your ministry. I believe that there are five important questions that one must consider. And I found these five questions within the writings of Ellen White, and these are questions that I reflect on each year that I go back to. They're written January 2nd, 1902 in Signs of the Times. I found these questions to be very, very useful in my ministry, so let me share them with you. So question number one, what advancement have we made in the knowledge of Christ during the past year? As you reflect, ask yourself, how did I grow? There are a number of times when I've had to process this as a pastor and as a student. In ministry, we seek to advance the work, but we can never allow the work to advance while our knowledge of Christ decreases. So, as you reflect on the year, ask yourself, ask your group, in what ways did my knowledge of Christ increase as a result of my ministry? Analyze the things you did, the things you do, and ask yourself, where did this lead me? Did it take me on a path of growing more in my relationship with Jesus? Asking yourself these questions will help you see the areas in which you need to grow. And growth is important. When you look back on your year, make sure that you're looking forward to how you're going to be growing the next year. Question number two, are we prepared to show more decidedly than ever before that we're on the Lord's side? I often have to pause and think this one through. It is not enough to just know about the Lord. We also must ask ourselves, what decisions did I make that demonstrate clearly that I am on God's side? The choices that I made this past year, how was Jesus reflected in them? Can anyone tell that I'm with Jesus? My demeanor, my attitude, and the way that I carried myself, did it all show that Jesus is my priority? I mean, how many people actually know that I'm a believer in my classroom, in my community? What does my personal witness look like? Is my relationship with Christ a secret? And if so, why is it a secret? This is important to think about because you will be able to identify the areas that you're afraid or the areas of fear that you have in your heart when it comes to being a witness. Question number three, at this time when the nations of the world are wavering between infidelity and idolatry, are we prepared to stand as faithful ambassadors for Christ? When you look at the world around you and identify the problems, are you inspired and motivated to be an ambassador? This will help to clarify goals, this question. There are a number of challenges that I see right now that I'm praying about. But God is exposing and expanding many possibilities and opportunities for us in this world to do ministry despite the craziness of it. So look for those opportunities. Open your eyes. God is doing something very, very special and you need to see it. So you need to be willing to be an ambassador. So in your reflection, think about it. Question number four, shall we not at the beginning of this new year give ourselves and all we have to God? In what ways am I willing to surrender everything I have to the Lord? Are there things that I'm holding on to while doing ministry? This is an important point because many times we're not successful in ministry or growing in our relationship with God because we fail to surrender our lives to Him. The same measure in which we surrender will determine the measure for success in ministry. God will only use what we give to Him, and many could do more. Many can experience more success, more victories, if only they trusted the Lord and surrendered their lives to Him. So now for the final question. I like the way that this one is written, and I often have to pause in this one and really, really think about it. Shall we not listen to His voice, which calls us to a renewed contest, to a more thorough consecration of ourselves and our entrusted capabilities to His service? Always remember that the end of a year provides an opportunity to start anew. Don't just reflect. Ask yourself, what is God saying to me in this? When I read the Bible, what is God saying to me? Don't just read it to fulfill some task or duty. No, God is about relationship. How can I renew my commitment to Him? This time of reflection is an opportunity for renewal, a time for deeper consecration, a time for deeper commitment with God. This is important as you assess how you've used your time, your talents, your efforts, and make this the desire of your heart, that you give God your ability, your capabilities, everything you are, give it to Him. And like the Apostle Paul says to Timothy, fight the good fight of faith. Take hold of eternal life to which you were called and about which you made the good confession in the presence of many witnesses. 1 Timothy 6 and verse 12. I pray that God will bless you as you reflect together as a group and as you personally reflect on your ministry and on your life and on your relationship with Jesus.